So I got myself the iOptron iPolar here. It's supposed to help me with polar aligning, and this will be the first time I'm using it. The sky tonight is going to be beautiful. I have my telescope set up already. It's pointed towards the north. We're at an Airbnb, so I don't know exactly where Polaris would be, but I'm pointing it roughly at north, and I'm going to use this polar scope to align with Polaris. I have the Celestron Advanced VX. It comes with this iPolar for AVX adapter. Let's see if I can focus it. Yeah, so I'm going to put it into where my polar scope would be using this Allen wrench, and we're going to give it a go. I brought my Surface with me, my Microsoft Surface, to help me with the software piece, so we'll go to that next. So I'm going to remove the polar scope cap here and take out my little adapter. So it has a little screw here, the silver screw. I'm going to take this off so that it separates the piece for the actual camera. I believe where it goes is, so there are a couple of screws here that pop out on the sides. So I'm going to put this here. I'm going to screw it into place. This has been tightened. You know, not the easiest to put in, but it's fairly easy. Just gotta remember where your screws are. Next, I will take this. And I'm going to I'll align my little camera with the little hole here. Oops, oh, there's a screw here too. Should unscrew that so that it pops right in. And you can tighten it again so that the USB, micro USB, is popping out. Plug this back in and screw this in. So aside from installing the mount, the adapter that goes into the Advanced VX, it's pretty pretty easy and straightforward. So we can pop this out, and I'm gonna plug it in. So it has this super thick micro USB cable. Plug it into where I know it is, on the side here. I'm going to have my Surface on a little wicker chair. So I have the software running here, and I'll click on connect, and it takes a few seconds to initialize. So it has connected and is still initializing. And it's now asking me to plate solve. So we will then click on the settings. And you'll see that the latitude and longitude is here. So I put this in earlier. You can edit this to wherever your location is. And the next thing we want to do is take a dark frame to calibrate the camera. So if I cover the scope, you'll see it gets dark. And once we take a dark frame, it'll tell you to cover the camera and then uncover it when it's ready. And once it has done this, you can see what's on the screen. You can see the stars that the camera sees because it has correct exposure now. So at the current position, we'll confirm position one before we move it. So just setting everything up. You'll see position one is going in and out of being clickable because it's still trying to play itself. So I clicked on position one, so we'll give it a second. And there we go, position one has been confirmed at X and Y coordinates. The next thing we want to do is we want to move the mount at least 45 degrees, and it'll automatically confirm position two once it has moved enough. So after we moved it about 45 degrees, it automatically confirmed position 2 at X and Y coordinates. And at this point, you'll see a red dot on your screen. I apologize, it's a little bit off the screen here at the time of recording, which I didn't notice. And that red dot will be the celestial North Pole. So So now I'm going to start moving my alignment very slowly using the knobs on the mount to try and get the red dot right where the little crosshair is. You'll notice that as I move it, the stars on the screen start slowly slewing as well. So now you'll see that the red dot is on screen, it is moving up, and one of the things I like is that if you get close enough to the red dot, the software automatically zooms in, which is extremely helpful. And then you can make your fine adjustments from there. It takes a little bit of practice to know which way you are moving your mount and where the red dot is moving, but once you get the hang of it, it's just a little easy. And since we're making fine adjustments, the smallest changes make the red dot go farther than you actually intended to do, but that's quite all right. So once you have it in place, you'll know that it'll turn green right there, but you'll know that it doesn't stay green constantly. So the reason for this is because the atmosphere is moving all the time, so it goes in and out, and that's all right. So the method I use is, you know, if it's in there every couple seconds or so, then I can consider it polar aligned. This is a much better alignment than I would normally get anyway. So you can see the red dot does stay within the crosshairs. It stays green every once in a while, but it'll change. But once you're at this state, you can consider yourself polar aligned, unless you find yourself in a place where the atmosphere doesn't move at all, then maybe you can get it to stay green for a much longer period. But I can't get it to stay more than a second or so. But anyways, this is my polar alignment, and we will take a look at some of the pictures that I took tonight using the Advanced VX mount, polar aligned with iPolar, and let's take a look at what I was able to capture.